page 15. We will start at the Mishnah, page 14b. Sometimes, as we explained day before yesterday and yesterday, a person can committed one sin but has a lot of consequences that cause him or her to go, and as far as the offering can be exceeded to even five or six offering, and vice versa, when a person does a good deed, it can have a double, triple, and more effect. Here is a scenario. Habal chamoto chayav aleha mishum chamoto vekalato ve'eshet achi ve'eshet achi aviv ve'achot ishto ve'eshet ish ve'nida. So it means, if, and again it's a rare situation, but hypothetically speaking it can happen, one who cohabited with his in-law, which turned to be a one who married to his son from a different wife, and therefore is prohibited to him by Isu Kala, the daughter-in-law, the Torah said. And then if the husband of the in-law passed away and she married the brother, the surviving brother, so therefore it's prohibited Eshet Achi Aviv. And then if the second husband of his in-law passed away and she went and she married to the brother of his father, so that another prohibition of Eshet Achi Aviv. And if she's also the sister of his wife, and while she's married, and Nida. You can see in your chart examples they use here. In my chart, you have here such as the biblical names like Ishmael and Bosmat, and have Yehudit, who marry Reuven, who is the son of Yaakov and grandson of Yitzchak, who is brother of Esav, and have another son by Yaakov. After Reuven have Shimon, and Reuven have a son by the name of Hanoch. So you have the marriage, which is between Yehudit and Reuven. You have the prohibited Bi'at Isur between Ishmael and Bosmat. You have descendants of Ishmael and Bosmat, which is Yehudit, and the husband of Bosmat, that Shimon, in that sense, is the brother of Reuven. Another example is V'chen haba al em chamiv ve'al em chamoto. So again, this is a situation that it's applied to one who engages in relation with the mother of his father-in-law, or with the mother of his mother-in-law. So all of those is based on the book of Vayikra, the Leviticus, on those chapters 18, 19 that expand on that. But the idea is that have a accumulation of several Yisurim. And another situation, Rabbi Yochanan ben Nuri omer, habal chamoto chayav aleha mishum chamoto. If one engage with relation with his in-law, he's liable due to the unintentional violation of the prohibition of engaging in relation with his mother-in-law and the mother of his mother-in-law and the mother of his father-in-law. Ve'em chamoto ve'em chamiv chayav aleha mishum chamoto, em chamoto ve'em chamim amru lo shloshtam shem echadem. The sages said to him that those three prohibitions are basically under one roof, are one category of prohibition derived from the same verse. Because if you zoom in Vayikra chapter 18 verse 7, quote, you shall not uncover the nakedness of a woman and her daughter, you shall not take her son's daughter and her daughter's daughter. So consequently, one is not liable to bring separate sin offering for violating these prohibitions. Now the Gemara comment on the seifa, on the last clause of the Mishnah. Amar Rabbi Elazar, Amar Rabbi Yoshaya, Rabbi Yochanan ben Nuri v'Somchus amru davar echad. They're all, meaning both Rabbi Yochanan ben Nuri and Somchus, said, state the same, referring to the state in the Mishnah, the same thing, which is Rabbi Yochanan ben Nuri had the Amaran, which Rabbi Yochanan ben Nuri, it's referring to what we state in the Mishnah, that if someone cohabited with his in-law, that it's also the mother of his in-law and the mother of his father-in-law, he if it was unintentional, he needs to bring a three sin offerings. So mchus maihi, where do we find that the equivalent ruling of sumchus, the tenan, and that's referring to the Mishnah in Tractate Chulin, page 82, in regards to, in a way different isur, but obviously they have a connection, the prohibition of oto ve'ed bno. The Torah tells us in the book of Vayikra, Leviticus chapter 22, verse 28, when it's come to slaughter animal, v'shor oseh oto ve'ed bno lo tishchatu biyom echad. When you need to slaughter animals, so you cannot slaughter in the case of cruelty of the ox or lamb together with the offspring the same day. It's prohibited by our Torah, as we said in Leviticus chapter 22, verse 28. So therefore, page 15, Shchata ve'et bat bita. So Lichura, Rashi tells us that it lo avar isura, that it's not prohibited if one slaughtered an animal on its daughter. Ve'achar kach shachat bita, and only then he slaughtered the original animal daughters. Sofeget arba'im, which means that arba'im yakenu, that based on Gemara Makot 22 is a 39 malkot. In course of the 39 Malkot, based on Leviticus 22, verse 28. Somchos omer mishum Rabbi Meir sofeg 80, he received 80, because he slaughtered the third animal, as its mother and its daughter had already been slaughtered on that day. So it means that Somchos also maintained that when a person commits a signal act, and thereby commits two transgressions, they are derived from a single verse, he is liable to receive punishment for both violations. The Gemara rejected that. Amarava Dilma Lohi. So he said, perhaps it's not so, which means Rabbi Yochanan ben Uri will not agree with the ruling of Sumchus. Ad kan lo kamar Rabbi Yochanan ben Uri hacha, ela mishum shemot muchlakin. So it's possible that Rabbi Yochanan ben Uri says that one is liable to bring a multiple sin offering only here in a case of one who engaged in relation with his mother-in-law, only due to the differentiated names of the prohibitions. The Mikarya Chamoto, Mikarya Em Chamoto. She's called his mother-in-law and she is called his mother-in-law's mother. So even it's not mamash mechulakim, but based on Vayikra 17:18, it's since the Torah independently mentioned each of them. Aval gabei oto ve'et beno dekulhu. But when it's come to case of slaughtering mother and its offspring in a single day, where all the permutations are called a mother and its offspring, mikaryan, otoved no mikaryan, ve'en shemot mechulakin, de'en shemot mechulakim lo. So a mother and its offspring, there are no differentiated names given in our Torah for slaughtering a mother animal and then its offspring, or the slaughtering the offspring and subsequently its mother. So Rabbi Yochanan ben Uri might maintain that one is not liable to receive multiple sets of malkot. Another rejection, Amar Rabbi Nachman bar Yitzchak Dilma ad kan lo kamar somchus ela gabei oto ve'et bno degufin mechulakin. So somchus said only regard to a case of slaughtering the a mother and its offspring on the same day. So because we talk about differentiated body. So even if violated the same prohibition twice, he did it by slaughtering three different animals, the gufin muchlakin. Avalacha de ein gufin muchlakin. But here, when it comes to a in-laws, where there are not several differentiated bodies, as a man engaged in a relation with only one woman, one might say that some who's hold, in according to the statements of Rabbi Abau, Eima ki Rabbi Abau amar Rabbi Yochanan svira l'demar Rabbi Abau, amar Rabbi Yochanan she'era hena, Zimahi, when the Torah said in Leviticus 18, verse 17, they are near king's women its lowness, which means although these are different relationships, the verse rendered them all one single prohibition of lowness, for which only a single sin offering is brought. The next Mishnah Kedosha going to deal with a similar situation, which is the person needs to bring several sin offering for one cohabitation. Amar Rabbi Akiva shalti et Rabban Gamliel Rabbi Yeshua be'itlis. That's the meat market. Shel, the city called Emaum, or some said Emaos, that's in Judaica. The Yerushalmi in Shvi'it, chapter 9, expand on that. But the whole idea, Rabbi said that he wants to praise the Chachamim. Tosfot Yeshanim said that even though they are so occupied with purchasing the animal, they still can answer those questions. Shalchu likach b'ma lemishte, for they purchase animal for the special celebration of the marriage of Bno shel Rabban Gamliel, the son of Rabban Gamliel. Haba al achoto v'al achot aviv, someone cohabited with sister and the sister of his father, v'al achot imo, some said be'elem echad, Rashash comment, ma'u. So you mean to say chayav al achat kulan, chayav achat al kulan, so you need to bring a sin offering for all the three violations, or chayav al kol achat v'achat, or is... The Gemara expand on the question of Rabbi Akiva. Amru lo, Rabbi Gamliel, Rabbi Yeshua respond and said, lo shamanu, aval shamanu, abal chamesh nashav nidot be'elem echad. If someone cohabited with five wives while they are in nida, doing one lapse of a wellness, we heard that he is liable to bring a separate sin offering for having engaged in relation with each and every one of them. Shu chayav al kol achad v'achad, because each of them is separate body. Hona Shiro expand on that. But anyway, and they conclude and they said, V'ro'ani sh'advarim kal v'chomer. And it appears to me that these matters can be derived from a kal v'chomer if he is liable to bring a separate sin offering for having engaged in relation with five nidot who are forbidden by one prohibition, he should certainly be liable to bring a separate sin offering for having engaged in relation with his sister, sister in his father, sister of his mother, who are forbidden by three separate prohibitions. Now the Gemara expand on the question of Rabbi Akiva. Hey Chedami, what are the circumstances about which Rabbi Akiva inquired? Ileima ki dekatani, if you say that the circumstances are precisely as the Mishnah teaches them, that one unintentionally engaged in relation with his sister and the sister of his father and sister of his mother, then, mighty ba'ele, for what purpose did Rabbi Akiva raise the dilemma before Rabban Gamliel and Rabbi Yehoshua? Harei shemot muchlakin, harei gufin muchlakin, aren't they differentiated names of prohibition? And aren't they also differentiated bodies? So since the man engaged in relation with three women, who are forbidden by three distinct prohibitions, it is obvious that he is obligated to bring three separated sin offering. Ela hachikatani, that's what the Mishnah meant to say. Haba al achot aviv shi achot imo chayav al kol al kulan o chayav al kol achat v'achat mau. If someone cohabited with the sister of his father, that it also turns to be the sister of his mother, the sin offering applies to each and every isur, bi'ah, or the sin offering applies on all of them together. Mahu, some don't have the girsa mahu, but anyway, mi amrinan harei shemot muchlakin lin, o dilma harei en gufin muchlakin. Do we say that there are differentiate names of prohibitions, and since he violated distinct prohibitions, he is liable to bring a separate sin offering? Or perhaps we say it is not a case of differentiated bodies, since he engaged in relation with only one woman, he is liable to bring only one single offering. Amru lo, Rabban Gamliel and Rabbi Yoshua respond to him and said, Lo shamanu. We didn't hear a clear shmua, a clear ruling from our teachers in regards to this. Aval shamanu abal chamesh nashav nidot bevat achat shu shem echad. If one engaged in intercourse with each of his five wives while they are in the period, at the same time, which means doing one lapse of awareness, shechayav al kol achat v'achat mishum didan. So each and every one of them, he is in violation, is liable to bring a separate sin offering, because the prohibition against engaging with relation with nida. V'ra'inu shadvarim kal v'chomer. And it appears ostensibly that it is that three matters can be derived from a kal v'chomer. Uma bal chamesh nashav nidot v'at achat shi shem echad. If someone cohibited with five nidot that have, which is only one name of prohibitions, is nevertheless liable to bring a sin offering for each and every one of them. Then in a case of one who engaged in intercourse with his sister, who is also the sister of his father and the sister of his mother, אחותו שהיא אחות אביו שהיא אחות אמו של שלוש שלושה שמות אינו דין שיהיה חייב על כל אחד ואחד. It's not logical to say that he should be liable for each and every one of them. יקל מפרח, ומה אובג'קט זה דעת, מה לחמש נידות שכן גופין מוחלקין, that they have a differentiated bodies, which is not the case with regard to one's sister, who is also the sister of his father and the sister of his mother, as she is a single person. אלא אמר קרא, ערוות אחותו גילה, לתועסד לביליקוס, chapter 20, verse 17, he has uncovered his sister's nakedness. לחייב על אחותו שהיא אחות אביו, שהיא אחות אמו. So here you see a separate חיוב that applies to his sister, that's also sister of his father, and also sister of his mother. אמר רבא לבא רבא, משכחת לה ברשעה ברשיעה. That's applied to a man who is totally wicked, the son of a wicked man. שבעל אמו וליד שתי בנות, he cohibited his mother and have two daughters, וחזר ובעל אחת מהן וליד בת, and he cohibited one of those, his daughter, and have another son, ובא בנו על אחות אמו, שהיא אחותו, שהיא אחות אביו, and his son cohibited with the sister of his mother, that is also a sister of the, who is also his own sister, because they share a father, and who is also his father's sister. Unfortunately, it can happen, and this individual is absolutely a wicked man, the son of wicked man, as both he and his father engage in relation in such a illicit and violation relation. Tanu Rabbanan Baalei v'chazaru Baalei v'chazaru Baalei achayav al kol achat v'achat. Divrei Rabbi Eliezer, he engaged with relation with her, woman that is forbidden to him, need it again, need it again. So each and every one of them, he is liable to bring a separate sin offering. That's the view of Rabbi Eliezer. The sages hold that he is liable to bring only one sin offering. The sages concede with Rabbi Eliezer, with one who engaged in relation with five wives, who while they are in their period, at the same time, which means doing the one lapse of awareness, שהוא חייב על כל אחת ואחת, הועיל והוא גרם להם, because he, each of them, he caused to be liable to bring a sin offering. אמר רבא לרב נחמן, מי אמרינה, do we say that since the cause of each of them to be liable to bring a sin offering, he himself is liable to bring a five separate sin offering, והתניה, הוא בעלם אחד והיא בחמש העלמות, if he did it to one lapse of wellness and but she does doing five lapse of wellness, as she separately became aware of the prohibition and then forgot it because of the next transgression, who eno chayav al achad v'chayav al kol achad v'achad. So obviously he's liable to one versus her, she's liable to bring a separate sin offering for each and every one of them of the five transgressions. So in this case, although he caused to bring several sin offering, he himself bring only one sin offering. So as we said, that because they are differentiated bodies, so that the reason that he brings five sins offering, it's with five wives while they are in the period doing one lapse of onus, is because the five differentiated bodies. Ebaru lo katzar vekatzar mali amar a Rabbi Eliezer. Here we talk about Melechet Shabbat, that one who reaped a fig bark of grain on Shabbat, which is the measure for which one is liable to bring a sin offering, and then reaped another fig bark in a single lap of awareness. So what Rabbi Eliezer hold? Tamad Rabbi Eliezer ata mishum de hu avad tartein ועמתו להכי אמר וחייב על כל אחת ואחת הכנה מדעבד תרטן. He performed two separate acts of reaping, so he's liable to bring a separate sin offering for each one. או דילמה, or perhaps we said, תמד רבי אליעזר אתה משום די אפשר לו להרוון לביאות זו בזו, because he cannot combine the act of intercourse with one another. עמתו להכי אמר רבי אליעזר חייב על כל אחת ואחת, so therefore, consequently, רבי אליעזר said that he needs to bring a sin offering for each and every one of them. אבל קצר כגוגרת וחזר כקצר כגוגרת, you cannot compare it. If one reaped a fig bark of grain and then he did it again, בעלם אחד, כיוון דאפשר לו לערב שתי גורות ברד אחד, sin, he can combine the two fig barks of grain together and reap them. At the same time, he will be liable to bring only one sin offering, אינו חייב על אחת. מי, what is the correct explanation for Rabbi Eliezer's ruling? אמר רבא, תעמד רבי אליעזר, אתה משום דאבד תרתי, because he performed two separate acts of reaping, so he's liable to bring a two separate sin offering. Hachna med avad tartei, here's two. He did two acts. Rav Yosef amar tamad Rabbi Eliezer atam di efshar lo l'arvan, you can combine. Aval efshar, di efshar lo arvan, aval efshar lo arvan, you have l'achad. But if you can combine them, which means by reaping two fig bark or fig bark of grain, no have l'achad. He's liable to bring only one sin offering. Eiti veir abaye l'rabba. So he brings a raya from our braita. Rabbi Eliezer mechayev al vavdei melachot bimkom avot melachot. So here Rabbi Eliezer deems one liable to bring a separate sin offering for the performance of subcategories of prohibitions labor on Shabbat in a situation where he's also performed the corresponding primary categories of prohibition labor doing the same lap of awareness. Rabbi Eliezer mechayev al vavdei melachot bimkom avot melachot. So ha'av ve'av bevat achat patur. But if one perform a primary category of labor and then perform the same primary category at the same time doing the same laps of awareness, he's exempt from bringing the second sin offering. V'yamar tamad Rabbi Eliezer mishum dekavad tartei, amad patur, if you tell me that the reason of Rabbi Eliezer because he did two melachot, so why he is exempt from bringing a second sin offering for repeatedly performing a primary category of prohibited labor on Shabbat, when he's to perform a distinct prohibition act. Amar mar bril rabbanan, anna v'rav nechumei bar zechariyat targemina. So he said that Rav Nechumei bar Zecharia interpreted the braita as follows. Hachamayaskin, who are we dealing here? In the case that one, he is liable to bring two sin offerings for performing a primary category of prohibition labor and its subcategory. Bedalit hamudlet al gabei tehena uktsatsan bevat achat. So here you talk about situations which is rare, that he climbing a grapevine that is a trail set over a fig tree, and he cut them both, the grapevine and the figs, at the same time doing the one lap of awareness. So detaching the figs is one of the primary categories of the prohibited labor of harvesting, while pruning the vine in order to use it as fuel for a fire is a subcategory of harvesting. משומח מחייב רבי אליעזר הואיל ושמות מחולקים וגופים מחולקים. So that's the Rabbi Eliezer deemed liable because it's a differentiated names and a differentiated physical entity, as he detached figs and part of a grape vine. דכוותה קצר וקצר איכך משכחת לדמי פטר, כגון שקצר שתי גורגרות בבת אחת. like when he ripped two fig boxes simultaneously, אבל קצר כגרוגרת וחסר וקצר כגרוגרת חייב. But if one ripped a fig box of grain and then repeated, ripped another fig box, he is liable to bring two sin offerings as he performed two separate acts. Mishnah Kedosha. Here, another question that Rabbi Akiva asked Rabban Gamliel, Rabbi Yoshua, when they are in that meat store in the city of Im Um or Im Us. That's the way Abir Yaakov, Shoshnim Le David, and Beit David hold. Tiferet Israel have a little different touch, but that's dealing with the Tum'at Evarim, that detach from an animal or a person, but they have some very minor connection. It's called dangling Evarim Medul Dalim, which is a question of Ever Min HaChayes based on the Gemara in Chulin 129b that we study in the Pes, Vod Shal Rabbi Akiva. And furthermore, Rabbi Akiva asked Rabban Gamliel, Rabbi Yoshua, in that place, in the meat market of Amunos, Ever Medudel Bavema Mau, what's the status of a dangling limb of an animal? Does it impart ritual impurity like a severed limb? אמרו לו לא שמענו, we didn't hear the הלכה, אבל שמענו אבר המדודל באדם שהוא טהור, but we heard that when it's come to a dangling limb of a person that is ritually, ritually pure, וכך היו, in that manner, would, תדבר עמוד ב', 15b, מוכי שכין עושים בירושלים, people afflicted with boils, whose limbs were dangling due to their affliction act in Yerushalayim, just read the unfortunate story of our people in the past. It doesn't only happen during the Mishnaic time, it happens and reoccur in Yerushalayim, those eras that was a great famine to our days, but this talk back to those days. So the Rashash explained that because there's the issue of chatzitza, the dangling limb, so that's the truth is that is a disputation. The tour in Yoreh De'ah in Kuf Tzadik Chet in Shulchan Aruch disputed what exactly the status of Ever Meduldal, a dangling limb, if that's considering interposing when one duck in a mikveh or not. But anyway, Olech lo Erev Pesach Tzel Arofe V'chotcho, goes by Eve of Pesach to the Rofe, and those days, obviously it's different, and he will cut the affected limb almost completely. Ad shemaniach kis ara, I assume that we are talking more dermatological minor treatment, but anyway, v'tochavo besira v'nimshach mimeno. So he impaled the limb on a thorn affected to the floor on or the wall, and the afflicted will pull away from the throne, thereby completely severing the limb. So the person who have afflicted with boil will perform the rite of his paschal offering, and the doctors will do the same. So if a tangling limb in a person is pure, so how much so when it's come to animals? The Mishnah in Chulin 127, they said simply that evara medudal babema ino metame, that tingling limb in the animals not carry ritual impurity. That's the rivet comment here, based on the tshuva of Rabban Gamliel and Rabbi Yoshua. But over there, the Gemara in Chulin 127b, derived from the pasuk, Abir Yaakov said. But anyway, Michael Vachomer, it's not a time, I'm sorry. Some have this as a parenthesis, some have this as a girsa, so I'm just reading it. Michael, v'chomer, ma adam shem tamem echayim, ever amdudal bo tahor, v'ma shenam tamem et chayim, ever amdudal ba enodin shetahor. Nanatam, that's the Mishnah in Machshir in chapter 1, Mishnah 5. המוחק את הקרי שווה סוחט בשרו ובכסותו, משקה בשבר תוכם אינם בחיותן, ויוצאים ממנו הרן בחיותן. אמר שמול הוכרשה עצמה הוכשרה, מה איתמה בשעת פרישה ממנו הוכשרה? When it's the water separating from the leak is rendered susceptible to ritual impurity, by the very water which is released from it. ואתנן ערב פסח הולך לו צל וכולי, והיא אמרת בשעת פרישתן מוכשר, האיקה נמיה הוא עבר המדולדל, בשעת פרישתו מאדם נתמיי לאדם, כדי אמר רב יוסף, בניתזין בכל כוחן, הכנה מבניתזין בכל כוחן, ואיך היית מרד רב יוסף? אהה, זהבות ממד שהיו מלכים וירדו עליהם גשמים, אף על פי שסוחטין זה את זה, משקין הירודים מצד העליון לצד הלכתון תאורים, שאין מחשבין אלא שיצאו מכולן, יצאו מכולן הרי מכשירים, שאינם נחשבים אלא אחר שיצאו מגופו, אמר רב יוסף, בניתזין בכל כוחן. The third question that Rabbi Akiva asked his rabbis, ועוד שאלו רבי עקיבא, שוחט חמישה זבחים בחוץ בלם אחת, מה הוא חייב על כל אחת ואחת או אחת על כולן? אמרו לו, לא שמענו. אמר רבי יהושע, שמעתי באוכל מזבח אחד מחמישה תמחוין בלם אחד, שהוא חייב על כל אחת ואחת, משום מעילה, ורואה אני שהדברים קל וחומר. אמר רבי שמעון, לא כך שאלו רבי עקיבא, אלא באוכל נותר מחמישה זבחים בלם אחת. מה הוא חייב על כל אחת ואחת, או חייב על כולם, או חייב על כל אחת ואחת, אמרו לו, לא שמענו. הרי יהושע, שמעתי באוכל מזבח אחד בחמישה תמחוין בלם אחד, שהוא חייב על כל אחת ואחת, משום מעילה, מסיוז, ורואה לי שהדברים קל וחומר. אמר לו רבי עקיבא, אם הלכה נקבל, אם לדין יש תשובה, אמר לו, השב. אמר לו, ולא, אם אמרת במעילה שעשה בה את המאכיל כאוכל, ואת המהנה כאן נהנה, צירף את המילה לזמן מרובה, תאמר בנותר שאין בו אחת מאלו. גמרא, מה יקש לה לרבי שמעון? הכי קקש אלה, מה ראה לשוחט מאוכל? מה לאוכל שכן נהנה, אלא כך שאלו, האוכל נותר מחמישה זבחים באלם אחד, מה הוא? חייב על כל אחת ואחת או חייב על כולן? אמרו לו, לא שמענו. אמר רבי יהושע, שמעתי באוכל מזבח אחד מחמישה תמחוין באלם אחד, שחייב על כל אחת ואחת משום מעילה. ורואה אני שהדברים קל וחומר, מה מזבח אחד שהם גופים מוחלקים, חייב על כל אחד ואחד משום תמחוין מוחלקים. חמישה זבחים דגופים מוחלקים, לא כל שכן. דמישנתית שזה אסדת רבי שמעון סד, אמר רבי שמעון לא כך שאלו, אלא באוכל מזבח אחד נותר מחמישה זבחים באלם אחד מהו. חייב על כולנו, חייב על כל אחד ואחת, אמרו לו, לא שמענו. רבי יהושע אומר, שמעתי, באוכל מזבח אחד בחמישה תמחוין, שהוא חייב על כל אחד ואחד משום מעילה. ורואה אני שהדברים קל וחומר, אמר לו רבי עקיבא, אם הלכה נקבל וכו'. קיבלה רבי יהושע להתשובה מרבי עקיבא עולה. תשמע לתניה, אכל חמש חתיכות נותר מזבח אחד בלם אחד בחמישה תמחוין, אינו מביא להחטאת אחת, ועל לא הודעה שלהן אינו מביא להאשם תלוי אחת. מחמישה תמחוין בחמש העלמות מביא חטאת על כל אחת ואחת, ועל לא הודעה שלהן מביא האשם תלוי על כל אחת ואחת. מחמישה זבחים בלם אחד חייב. רבי יוסף ורבי יהודה אומר, אפילו אכל חמש חתיכות מחמישה זבחים באלם אחת, אינו מביא להחטאת אחת. ועל ספיקן, אין מביא להאשם תלוי אחת. כללו של דבר, כל שחלוקים בחטאות, חלוקים באשמות. אכל חמש חתיכות בחמישה תמחוין מזבח אחד לפני זריקת דמים. אפילו באלם אחת, חייב על כל אחת ואחת משום מעילה. פייג' 16, ואילו על ספיקו, מביא השם תלוי לא קטני, מה נהה? אילה אם הרבי עקיבא ליתנה מספה ועל ספקן מביאה שם תלוי. דעתנן רבי עקיבא מחייב על ספק מעילה השם תלוי ללב רבי יהושע היא וקטנה בחמש האלמות מביא חמש חטאות ושמאמינה קיבלה מיני. אלא עד הרבה מספה דקטנה מחמישה זבחים אפילו בלם אחת חייב על כל אחת ואחת שמאמינה לא קיבלה מיני. ואלא מה התלמימר? תנאי היא דאי קטנה דקיבלה, והיא קטנה דלא קיבלה. אפילו תמר רבי עקיבא היא, והתנא סבר לקבטה בחדה ופליג עלי בחדה, סבר לקבטה בעלמה ופליג עלי במעילות. היחידה מחמש מעילות, אמר שמואל קוטה ששנינו, חמישה דברים בעולם מצטרפים, הבשר והחלב והיין והסולד והשמן. חזקי אמר כגון שאכל מחמישה איברים. ריש לקיש אמר אפילו תמר בעבר אחד, משכח לה בכתף. רבי יצחק נפחה אמר כגון שאכל בחמישה מיני גדרה. רבי יוחנן אמר כגון שאכל בחמישה טעמים.